In Putin's Russia, Eurovision video watches you! Welcome to Overthinking It, where we subject the popular culture to a level of scrutiny it probably doesn't deserve. I'm Mark Lee with the latest installment in our Eurovision 2013 review. Russia does not mess around when it comes to Eurovision. Since they debuted in 1994, you know, after that whole Soviet thing, they've never missed the semifinals. In 2009, they took top prize with Believe, the one with the Stradivarius violin and the ice skater. And in 2012, they took second place with the singing group of grandmothers that baked a batch of cookies on stage. This year is no exception. Here's Dina Garipova performing the soaring power ballad, What If?
What if I could make you all believe? If we, what if we all opened our arms? What if we came together as one?
This song has a lot going for it. Dina Garipova does her best Kelly Clarkson impression and displays an impressive vocal range. Oh, and I'm a big sucker for power ballads, having done one myself a few years ago. But this is Eurovision. This song would be unremarkable if there wasn't anything to make it really over the top. Okay, here it comes. Over the course of this video, we see people in the audience become so moved by this song that they burst into tears, join hands with strangers, rise to their feet as one global family, and gain the ability to clap vigorously while still holding hands with each other. I'm sorry, I was just so overwhelmed by the beauty of it all, and... Hey, I think I was just manipulated by pop culture. See this weeping woman? This ecstatic crowd buoyed by the power of this music? All intended to manipulate us, the viewers, into feeling similarly inspired. Oh, and to vote for the song in the competition, of course. Is manipulation in pop culture always bad? No. In fact, it's intrinsic to any piece of art that's trying to make us feel or think a particular way. Consider this famous scene from Star Wars. Luke Skywalker is staring into the sunset, longing for adventure and an escape from his dreary existence. That is the sound of manipulation. The music is telling you how to feel. It's instilling an emotion in you that you wouldn't feel otherwise. Now, watch this clip again, this time without the music. This doesn't work at all. It provokes little to no response without the music. With it, it's a beautiful, memorable moment that tells us a lot about Luke's character and foreshadows the adventure he's about to go on. So there's manipulation, and then there's manipulation. Consider the 2012 film Extremely Loud and Incredibly Close, which critics derided as extremely loud and incredibly manipulative. The movie's detractors labeled the graphic portrayal of the September 11th attacks and the overall weakness of the characters as cheap tricks that were trying to force an emotional response from the audience. Of course, one man's cheap trick is another man's masterful use of the tools of the craft to tell a powerful story. So how are we supposed to tell the difference between the two? What makes one instance of manipulation cheap, and another instance of manipulation masterful? When dealing with these distinctions that are both subjective and at the same time mostly obvious, I like to fall back to Supreme Court Justice Potter Stewart's famous quote on how to determine if something is obscenity as opposed to speech protected by the First Amendment. I know it when I see it. I don't know which is more hilarious, imagining Justice Stewart watching porn or imagining him watching Eurovision. What if we But I do know that Russia's music video is a great example of cheap manipulation in pop culture, and that this song is going to need a lot more than a gimmicky video to win votes. Even though the song really is pretty good on its own. Actually, it's better than good. It's great. Oh god, it's so beautiful. I'm sorry, I just can't help myself. That's it for this edition of Overthinking Eurovision. Leave a comment below, subscribe to our channel, and visit us on the web at overthinking.com, where we subject the popular culture to level scrutiny it probably doesn't deserve.